Greetings, and thank you for joining me on my channel. I'm Armin, and today's video is about modeling a propeller in ANSYS Fluent. In part 1, I covered the preparation of the propeller and the definition of both rotary and stationary domains. Part 2 took us through the process of creating the mesh. Now we'll explore the setup in ANSYS Fluent together. Before diving into this video, I highly recommend that you watch both part 1 and part 2 to get a comprehensive understanding of the propeller modeling. So, let's begin. I'm gonna double-click on Setup. Fluent Launcher was adjusted in the Mesh section. Here, we can choose Transient or Steady Response. Selecting a suitable viscous model plays a crucial role in propeller modeling. K-omega-SST is best for the steady-state solution of the propeller. This model combines the strengths of both the K-epsilon and K-omega models. Here, there are two domains that I select: the rotary domain. In this window, we can specify the speed of propeller, rotation, and origin of axis. In the steady state solution, we have to choose frame motion. Frame motion is also known as the MRF approach. I'm going to set 2000 RPM for the propeller. I have to change the unit of speed. In boundary conditions, we can check that all boundaries are well defined. Half of the propeller can be seen. We want to see the whole propeller. In the View tab, I'm going to click on Periodic Instancing. I define periodic boundary conditions on the rotary domain. So I'm going to choose it and click on Detect Surfaces. Now, we can see the whole of the propeller. It's like the circular pattern in CAD software. Piezo and pimple are recommended in articles. Based on my experience, the settings should be like this. Under relaxation factor of pressure is too low, so I'm gonna increase it. After all the steps, I'm gonna hit on the initialize. I want to create the velocity contour. I'd better create a plane to see the velocity of air. It should be noted that activating the symmetry display will also show the propeller symmetrically. Of course, this does not affect the answer. We have to specify the number of iterations in the run calculation window. It must be large enough that the solution will be converged. After 200 iterations, the answer has not yet converged, but this is enough for a tutorial video. This is contour of velocity. We can see Y plus from here. The value of y plus should be less than 5. I have a video about it. Please watch it. The mesh quality is poor. The quality of the mesh for the propeller must be excellent. The force on the propeller can be calculated like this. If I click on print, the force is shown in the console window. All right, I will now close the setup window and proceed to the results. By clicking on function calculator, we can calculate force and moment of propeller. Be sure to choose the right direction of force. Also, we can calculate torque of propeller from here. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel.